I was recently coding a scenario where the patient was a 20-year-old obese patient and received an error with the BMI code that I selected. The error indicated the code I reported was not correct for the patient age. I used the adult codes. Why would this be wrong? Is it an error in our electronic medical record programming? This was a question that I find actually a number of people run into pretty frequently in ICD-10. Alicia, if you want to go ahead and click the answer sheet, that'd be great. Okay, so the reason that the person probably received this error had nothing to do with the programming in the claim scrubbing or the electronic medical record, which is the question that they had. If you can scroll down a little bit, Alicia, what you actually find in ICD-10 is that for body mass index, when a patient is considered an adult is not until the age of 21. They have to be 21 or older to be considered an adult in ICD-10-CM for body mass index. Now, that's different than what we've been taught in many other areas, right? Most of the time we think 18 is an adult. Well, that's true except for body mass index for these cases. And what the ICD-10 manual actually says is if the patient is between the ages of 2 and 20, you have to use the pediatric codes for body mass index. Well, the difference between the adult codes and the children codes, the adult codes, you select what range the patient's body mass index is in. For the child codes, you're selecting what percentage of a growth chart that body mass index is in. And most of us are going, wait a minute, what if our physician didn't use a growth chart because this patient is 20 years old? Okay, you can find one because the guidelines clearly state it's based on the growth charts from the CDC or the Centers for Disease Control. So what we want to do is we want to pull up one of those, length for age, weight for age, files. So you can open the top one that says black and white, or you can open the color one, whatever you prefer. So when we plot the body mass index, because oftentimes for those adult patients, right, the ones we think should be adults, 19, 20-year-olds, the provider's going to write down what their body mass index is or their height-weight ratio, and we can determine the BMI. All you have to do is look here to see where do they fall, because these little pink lines, the kind of squiggly ones, you'll notice that top one says 95, the one below it says 90, the one below it says 85. Those are the percentiles where they fall in that percentile growth chart. And when you look at the body mass index codes for children, which go up to age 20, you have to know what percentage of the growth chart they fall in. So in this case, if they had a body mass index of 32, they would be in the 95th, in or above the 95th percentile for height and weight for their age and gender. And that's what you have to know to select the correct codes. Can you go back to my answer sheet for me, Alicia? So I included an example here, and let's talk through this. This is an example, and this is actually another one of the questions off of the pre-employment exam that's coming for risk adjustment. And this is one that I used to get a lot when I worked in the risk adjustment hiring of coders environment. This was one that we would give to new coders to see if they understood the difference between the two. So this is a 20-year-old morbidly obese patient who has a body mass index of 43.2. Well, we do know that we have to have two codes, hopefully. If you've looked at the guidelines for obesity, you've got a code, the first code for the morbid obesity, the E66.01, which does default to morbid obesity due to excess calorie intake, and that's straight from the index, and the tabular will verify that's the correct code. It then says underneath that code, use an additional code to identify the patient's body mass index. Well, this is a 20-year-old. They fall into the children's codes. We don't know their height. We don't know their weight. We don't even know their gender. All we know is their body mass index. We can still code this one. And the reason we can still code this one, if we were to look at those growth charts again, Alicia, go over to that last growth chart that we pulled up. This patient's body mass index was 43-something. Well, the highest level code that we have options for BMI is 95th percentile or above. Well, they're there as soon as they hit 32. This patient's 43. this is just the girls one. Well, if you go look at the boys, you're actually going to find it's a little higher BMI, but 43 is still well above the 95th percentile. Okay. So we're able to know it doesn't matter gender, they're going to be in that 95th percentile or higher code, which is the, if you go back to my answer sheet, is the, I believe it's a Z68.54. Okay. So that's why we can go ahead and use that code. We don't have to know their gender. Everything we need is right there in that answer. I did want to point out, I've had a number of people ask me, well, for BMI, can't those ever go first? No. A BMI code, body mass index code, that Z68, should never be your primary or first listed diagnosis code. Those codes are considered supplemental or informational, and they're intended to be used as additional codes to further clarify how severe the obesity or the overweight issue may be. So you shouldn't have those as your primary diagnosis code. So just to wrap up, when you're looking at body mass index, remember, if the patient is between the ages of 2 and 20, they're considered a child, and you have to use the percentile on the growth chart and have access to those CDC growth charts. They're not an adult until they're age 21, where you can actually just pick the BMI range that they fall into.
Very exciting. And it makes perfect sense why this would be on a pre-employment exam.
Do you need more medical certification training? Go to www.cco.us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for updates.